Hello everyone, and welcome to another review. First off, let me apologise for my absence. And the reason for that is I achieved something which I've always wanted to achieve, and I have bought myself a 3.5 inch gauge loco, and I've been taking it down to the local model engineering club in Hayward's Heath. I will do a separate video on that loco at another time. Hopefully in this intro, this video, I will put a picture up at least of the loco in question. But today the main focus of this video is the loco you see before you, which is the spectacular Brighton Atlantics, or the London, Brighton and South Coast H2 locomotives. And what other loco to best represent the video and the class? The number 32424 Beachy Head, the one that is being built from scratch at the Bluebell, and it's going to be a new build, a bit like Tornado, except this is southern, that is northern. And I thought, since it's a Bluebell loco, soon to be hopefully the crown jewel in their collection, why not do a double header with 473, another London Brighton loco, Birch Grove, as it's affectionately known and was named in its LB&SC days. And as the headboard says on the front, we'll be doing the Grinny Flyer, also known as East Grinstead, to those who don't know, but it's quite a nice little comical headboard you get with this loco. Yeah, usual things. You got discs, lamps for all of the lamp brackets. Number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and assuming 6. I assume as well for the tender. Looking over the loco, a superb model and immaculate detail as well. I mean, when Caledonia Works released the Northern Atlantics, I bought that as well. Stupidly thinking it was the Southern Atlantics, but no, this is the Southern Atlantics, and I couldn't wait for him to release it, as well as the, as I'm sure I've mentioned in another video, I think he's going to get round to making a Q-class, a U-boat, and I think a Schools, I believe, but it's all on his page. I will also put a link in the description to his website where you can buy the loco, and for £14, it's... again, absolute bargain for the amount of detail and everything you get in this pack. But anyway, I believe I've waffled on enough, so let's drive up to East Grinstead. Then once we get there, I will then show you the manual, where I'll pause over the history and you can read it for yourself. But anyway, let's enjoy this beautiful loco, the beautiful sounds and the beautiful Bluebell Railway. Anyway. With this as well, you've got a reversing lock. You have a cab views as well, got the usual stuff from Caledonia Works. Head out up here by the boiler and safety valves. It's got 4 safety valves, which is quite, shows you how much power this loco had, but just didn't have enough driving wheels to put it down, so these were prone to slipping quite a bit. But again, looking at the beautiful detail, including the whistle. We'll get to the sounds later. So we've got up there, back in here, driver's position, down by the firebox, up by the tender, which is usually where I would be sitting, say the third man position. Fireman, head out again, up by the safety valves, the beautiful and much favoured wheel view. Obviously you can't see it because there's a fence in the way. Up by the smoke box, down again by the wheels, up here by the front of the loco, down here again, centre, here, there, and everywhere. And again down by the wheels, we'll get some shots of that as we go along. Up there again. So I've got... yeah, that locked in. Set the brakes off. Another thing as well that is included is 3D nameplates. Oh, that's nice, that is. I think they're going to work in as a pair. Because as soon as I took the brake off in that, the brake came off on this as well. You can hear it as well. Ooh, it's going to be a good double-header. It's going to be a great one. Anyway, again, without further ado, I keep saying it. Without further ado, let's get on with it. Space whistle. It's quite a, well, I say quite a nice whistle. It is a very nice whistle compared to his other whistles on the locos. Something you do notice if you've been playing Train Simulator and buying add-ons from particular retailers is that they do, how would you say it? Not upgrade, but they do get better with their skills of developing locomotives. And I've noticed that with specifically Caledonia Works, from his buying his first add-on to buying this, he's come a very long way. He really has, in terms of texture, sound, modelling, scripting, you name it. He's come a very long way. But again, I'm going to stop waffling. I'm going to get on with it. So I hope you enjoy the video, and I'll see you at Grinny. Beautiful locomotive, it really is. A real mixture of carriages as well. It's a bit strange. I know it sounds stupid as well, but these locos to me are so photogenic as well. You can just take a picture of them at any angle and they just look amazing. They really do. Oh, wow. Okay. Thank you. Oh. Well then, what can I say? It's a superb engine. Here we're at the end of the line. Well, yeah. What I'll do next is show you the manual. But if you enjoyed the video so far, please hit the subscribe button. And if you like the video, please hit like. And if you want to receive notifications whether I've uploaded another video or review or whatever, please hit the bell next to the subscribe button. And I will see you in the next video. But before I disappear, I will show you the manual. So here's the manual. It's what you get standard with all Caledonia Works locos. So it's the London Brighton South Coast Railway Class H2. This is what it looks like in marsh umber. If you want to read the entire history of the loco, it is rather interesting. You can obviously read it once you've purchased the loco yourself. And obviously, it references the new build Beachy Head at the Bluebell, where you can donate. There's also a link there as well if you copy and paste that or click on it. Specifications are there, features, quick drive. It also has, you can also quick drive with the Pullman set. It gives you the option where to get the carriages you can quick drive with. Just click the link, it'll take you to there, and it's up to you whether you want to buy it. Here's the liveries. As you can see, you've got quite a wide selection. That's only the first half, I think there's one there as well. That's the one we just drove. Controls as well, there's quite a few controls. Performance, how-tos. You get the gist, there's all everyone that it thanks. There's a few famous people in there. If you know, you know. Anyway, I'm going to draw this video to an end. Thank you once again for watching and taking the time out of your day to watch my videos. It does mean a lot. The channel now is close to 20 subscribers at this point. So thank you again for your dedication. And I will see you in the next review and the next video. Goodbye.